Welcome everybody to Saturday, October 24th. We finally got our kids to bed, and it's been
a whirlwind of a couple of days.
Yeah. So last time we talked, we were bringing Ethan home, and so we brought him home in an ambulance ride late Tuesday night. Mm-hmm. And
kudos to the medical people at Davis that made that possible, because they pulled every miracle to get us home that day. And I don't even know all that was involved, but I know it was a lot. So we're really thankful that when we said we were ready to go home, they said okay, and
they got us home.
Yeah.
So that involved getting hospice involved, getting people that would kind of help us. Stephanie took a crash course in being a registered nurse, but, you know.
Really qualified.
We got a bed and some other things to get set up. And so when we came in Tuesday night, we were set up for success. And so we delivered meds, and we kept Ethan comfortable. Yeah. And
he never really regained consciousness, since since before we decided to bring him home.
Yeah. And we decided kind of Tuesday morning when we noticed Ethan was declining. And I would say the last cognitive reaction is we do like a 3-hand squeeze for I love you. And Ethan gave Stephanie a 3-hand squeeze.
He loves me.
A lot. That was early Tuesday morning. So,
but we didn't really expect him to regain consciousness. You know, the fluid was building up again.
Yeah.
And that just creates a ton of cranial pressure. And so, he was on his meds. I don't think he was any pain. You know, I don't know what degree of cognitive function, you know, maybe he could hear us, maybe he couldn't. But I think at that point, it was kind of the long journey of him physically passing away. But it was nice to be at home, you know, this is his home.
Yeah. And, you know, you kind of take away some of the, craziness of the hospital for the kids. Like, you want family to be able to be a part of this and say their goodbyes and have closure and not feel like, okay, we've got to take the kids to the hospital and we've got like 2 hours to
make it special.
Yeah. And so it was really nice to have the 2 days to
just let it run its natural course.
Yeah.
And there's no timeline attached. No one's waiting for anything. Like, Ethan's body can do what it needed to do to be done.
Yeah.
And we were just kind of witnesses to it. So, you know, I think it was good for Polly and Judah especially to see it in a limited way. You know, it was kind of hard. I didn't want to like push them to have them watch too much or to have some, you know, lasting memory.
Or a traumatic experience.
Yeah, you know, it didn't really look like Ethan. You know, he really looked like one of those sick, dying cancer patients, you know, that was a shell of who he once was. And so, you know, I wanted them to see enough to know that he was dying and that, you know, have some closure in that regard, but also not like make this traumatizing last memory when they have so many good memories. So I think we did okay. I think some counseling is probably in our future. And that's okay.
Yeah.
So his grandparents were with him. You know, he was never alone once he was home.
Yeah.
And that was always, I think, important to him. Like, you know, he didn't want to be alone. Yeah. So he passed away Thursday night on the 22nd.
At about 8:10.
And that was actually kind of a relief, you know.
Yeah.
It was a long journey, but I'm glad that his journey was complete.
Yeah. Yeah. So, life has continued, and Holly's birthday is today. She turned 9. And so she had been planning her birthday party
since the last 364 days.
Yeah. So she had decorations made, and so, you know, we...
What do you do? Like, what do you, you can't cancel a birthday. Like, no. And so, she's, I don't know, you just do it.
So it was... It was good timing in the sense that after Ethan passed away, you have some logistical things that you have to take care of. And so my youth pastor from the past came and picked...
He works for the funeral home
now. Yeah, he works for the funeral home now. And he came and prayed with us. And we took Ethan out and got him to the morgue on Thursday night. I mean, they did. And then, you know, I didn't want the kids to watch that. And so it was kind of nice that it was in the night. And, you know, the next morning, Friday morning, everything has been reset. Yeah. And, but the kids knew that Ethan had passed. And so it was nice to bring closure, but at the same time, start
a fresh day.
Yeah, on a fresh day. And so Holly had her birthday party with her friends and had a great time. And today we had family over and...
Well, and Holly's birthday has also been a reason for family to be together other than just being sad about Ethan.
Yeah.
It's like, we are sad about Ethan and we do want to be together, but Holly's birthday is a better reason to be together.
Yeah. And to celebrate. And we have been in solitude for the last 2 months, and it's really nice to have be together. Yeah, and talk and grieve and process together, because we're all hurting. But I think that it's really nice that we can just talk and know how one another is feeling and talk about our thoughts and share memories. And so I think it's very appropriate.
Yeah. A lot of people have been asking how we're doing, and we don't really know. We're just kind of doing.
Yeah. I also do think that we have been processing this a little bit more over the past couple of weeks. I think that we've kind of known since Ethan's diagnosis of what kind of tumor it was. And
from the surgery. I mean, there was a point in the ICU where I didn't know that he was going to make it. And so I don't think that we've ever been super naive about the reality of
this tumor
situation. You know, I think we were really hopeful that we could bring him home
and have more good days.
Yeah. Even though we figured those would be pretty limited.
Yeah.
You know, a week ago, I certainly didn't think that we would be here doing this. And, you know, we took him to the hospital on August 23rd, and he died on October 22nd. So, you know, it's been a really wild 2 months. I don't know, even though the days in the hospital were really long, like, this whole season just seems like a blur.
Yeah.
And so I think as we sift through that, you know, and as things calm down here, when they do, you know.
Right.
I think that emptiness will hit a deeper, deeper empty.
And I think it's going to come and go in waves, and we're going to be fine. And then something is going to jog your memory and tug at your heart and, you know, feel those feelings. And it's okay to be so sad that, you know, our son is gone. But I can also rejoice that our other three kids are doing great and rejoice.
We hope they're doing great.
On the outside, it looks like they're doing really great. So we're...
You can pray for us, please. Ethan might be okay now, but we'll see how we...
Yeah, and...
We're making margin. Joey and I are both off work until Christmas.
Yeah.
So I think that's really good. You know, as much as Ethan went through at the hospital these last two months, you know, our other three kids and the two of us, you know, it has been a lot.
And a strain. In
a different way. But, you know, the other kids have certainly been through their own tragic dysfunction, even though that they were in the loving hands of their extended family, like it hasn't been easy for them. And so I think taking time to finish the chapter book that Holly and I were reading in August, you know, I think we have 2 chapters left and we haven't done our normal routine of reading at bedtime and just sitting down for family dinner. It just hasn't really happened. Yeah. So I think getting those routines back, even though there's an empty chair, will be good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Well, we'll take some time and regroup and reestablish ourselves. And I think that's good for us. Mm-hmm. In terms of Ethan, we think that we're going to have his celebration of life in February, right around President's Day. And we're hoping that some of the regulations get lifted so that we can have all of Ethan's friends and family and community come. And I don't want to be limited to 100 or 200 people.
Big party. Lots of cake.
Lots of cake.
All the good stuff.
All the good stuff. And so that'll give us time to grieve and process, but also give us time to enjoy planning a party for Ethan in memory and celebration of him.
And just for the record, we make these videos when we're in a good mental space.
Yeah.
So, you know, I know on these videos we
can seem composed and
we are, but we're also, you know, there's a lot of times where it's like, you want to make a video? No, not now.
Yeah. Or I was mowing the lawn the other day and I was just, you know, you're thinking as you're mowing the lawn and I just was crying, mowing the lawn just because I was sad.
So, you know, we make these videos when we're in a good mental space to do it. And I just wanted to add that in.
Yeah. Don't think that we've got it all together.
We don't. I mean, mostly.
Most of the time.
So, we heard a statistic that 85% of marriages that experience the loss of a child end in divorce. And, you know, that's a really staggering and sobering statistic about the reality of how hard this is on the family structure. So, you know, I think our decisions that we make in the next couple months, in the next year, you know, we've always tried to be intentional, but I think getting it right going forward, getting the big things right, is going to be really important for our family and for our kids. And so I know a lot of you are praying for us, and you know, you can please continue praying for us because, you know, Ethan's journey is done, but ours isn't. And we want a good family, and we want solid, stable, and we can be sad, but we also want to
live in joy and rejoice for the days that we are given.
So thank you for all your prayers and encouragement. A lot of the people on Facebook are putting succulents as their little cover photos, and you know, those are little things that are really touching and they really mean a lot. Got people bringing meals and just all those things, sending flowers, and it's just really touching to know that people are thinking about us and thinking about Ethan and grieving with us and carrying the burden with us. So it feels good to be loved.
Yeah, we are. We're loved. We're surrounded.
All right, we're crying, so I guess we're done. I guess we'll update you guys when we have something significant to say. Yep. And that's that.
Yep.
All right.
Till next time.
Die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. soar, I'll fly away to a land on God's celestial shore.